tired out, foot sore, bathing in sweat as the weight of the pack, coated with mud from the sides of the trenches, and cursing the Kaiser and his men at every step. In 40 minutes from entering the trenches, we arrive at the firing line in an exhausted condition. And relief is quietly carried out, as if man knows his sentry post, and if he does not, there is no bother for him. We never take off any clothing or boots all the time in the trenches, and always have to wear the skeleton equipment. The rifle never leaves our hands. Of course, there are a thousand and one more things to put up with. I have given you a few inconveniences. I am trying to keep cheerful through it all, and hope to come through all right. Now I shall have to close as my candle is nearly finished. We lay our faces in the snow, while shells did everything that hit us. You see a flash, and then wait a long time before hearing the boom and the shriek of the shell passing over our heads. Almost together, and look around quickly and see the burst of the shell in or over the trenches sometimes before hearing the explosion. The first thing that shells into us is the bang of the explosion. And it is too late to get out of the way. The artillery fire there was absolutely frantic. Nearly every shell landed in the trench. Some men were buried alive while others were blown into the air. Officer Wallen's squad had dug the deepest hole into the side of the trench for protection. The two shells landed directly on top of them, and six men were entombed inside. We immediately began tearing away at the earth, and could hear someone shouting. But our rescue efforts did not save everything. Fear. You've got to be in it to understand what it means. Really, fear is any moment to be blown to smithereens. These shells coming over one after another, screeching, one after another.